every time. I still fill out the instructions like I don't know what to do. Baby number five. It is about a week and a half later from those clips that you just saw. And if you didn't get it from those clips, well, we are expecting baby number five. Today I'm sitting at my doctor's office. We're about to go in for my first appointment. Oh, I'm so excited. Y'all, I don't know if it came across in those videos or in those clips, but I was genuinely shocked and surprised to find out that I was pregnant. Not that I didn't know that it was a possibility, but if you've been around, if you know a little bit about our story, there's a almost 6-year age gap between our last two. And during that time, I really felt like God was telling me that he was going to give us more children, but it wasn't happening. And it was a very emotional and stressful long journey, and I kind of assumed that if we ever had any more kids, it would be the same way. But God is powerful and he is mighty, and he has blessed us. Wyatt just turned 11 months old a couple of days ago, and we're having another baby, and I'm so excited, so blessed, and so happy. But I was genuinely shocked and surprised. I'm going in for this appointment today. We're gonna see the doctor and then have an ultrasound just to make sure everything's looking good. We've, again, struggles in the past. This is actually my 9th pregnancy. We have 4 children here on this earth with us. We've lost 4 pregnancies. We have lost 4 babies. I feel like over the years, we've kind of figured out what was going on there. As a matter of fact, my doctor has already had me on some medication as soon as I found out that I was pregnant. So I'm hoping that we go in today and everything looks wonderful. That's my prayer. And I would certainly appreciate all of you praying for us and praying for this baby and for this pregnancy. All right. I don't know how much I can film in here today, but I'm going to take the camera in. We'll just see. And I'll be sure to update you as soon as I get done. Well, we got a lot accomplished in that appointment today. I was looking for my pictures. Let me show you. How exciting is that? It's so good to hear those words. I see a baby and I see a heartbeat. We also got blood work done today. And I talked to Justin and we decided to do the sneak peek blood work for gender. So I'm headed to drop that off now. And they said we should get an email tomorrow with that information in it. I kind of told Justin, let's just wait and find out when this one's born. And wouldn't that be so fun? He's like, no, that doesn't sound fun. He has never been about that. I've suggested it a few times. He's like, no, that doesn't sound fun. And I want to know too. So this is the first time we've done this though. The first time that we've ever found out this early with blood work. So hopefully it all goes well. She said that, you know, the results, they've not had any wrong results so far. And I think just once they've had it come back saying, probably need to do the blood work again. So that'd probably be my luck, wouldn't it? Maybe not. Maybe tomorrow we'll know if this is a little boy or a little girl. I kind of want to make a guess. I don't know. We're kind of on that boy kick. We've had 3 boys in a row now, so I don't know. I really don't have a guess, I don't think. Maybe we'll find out tomorrow. I gotta go drop it off, though, but overall, that appointment went so well. And I'm glad that it did. I get a little nervous going into those first appointments, but it went well.
It's another week later now, and before I finish this video, I thought I would sit down and do a little bit of an update for you and kind of let you know how I've been feeling and what's been going on. I do plan on doing an update each trimester like I did with Wyatt. I enjoy going back and watching those. I hope some people found them helpful, and I think it's a great way for y'all to just be a part of this with me and know what's going on. And so I do plan on doing that again, but I thought it would be fun to kind of include a little bit of that here in this video as well. Right now, while I'm sitting here filming this, I'm 9 weeks pregnant. I'll be a little bit further along probably when y'all see it, but right now I'm 9 weeks and it's been tough. It has been tough, and I expected that. I have had morning sickness, which has been all day, all night sickness with all of my successful pregnancies, especially the last 3. So I kind of expected that to happen. And if you've been there before with this kind of extreme morning sickness, you know what I'm talking about, but it's hard to describe. If you've not experienced it, it's hard to describe. Like, can't get out of the bed, can't function, can't even put a thought together because I just feel so sick. Don't want to eat, it's tough. It's really, really tough. And having 4 other kids, I can't do that. And as much as I don't like taking medicine, especially while I'm pregnant, I know when I need it, I need it. And so the doctor has got me on some medication, the same thing I took with Wyatt, that is helping. I can at least get up and function, and I'm so very thankful for that. Hopefully and prayerfully, within the next few weeks, I'll start feeling better. With my others, with Wyatt, I think I was right around 14 weeks probably when I started feeling better. And so hopefully that happens again. Hopefully I stay healthy, baby stays healthy, and maybe soon I will be feeling better. But like I said, the medication does help me at least be able to function, and I am so thankful for that. I'm feeling blessed, y'all. Still a little bit in shock. Normally, I'm like 4 weeks pregnant. I'm taking a test, looking up, having to hold it just right to the light to see if there's a line. And this time was a little bit different. I was almost 6 weeks when I found out, and I just wasn't really expecting it. And so it's been a little bit of a shock, and it's starting to sink in, like this is really happening, but still a little bit of a shock. And also talking about being sick, I usually always start getting sick at 6 weeks. And so usually I've known for a couple weeks before that, and I like mentally prepare myself. And this time I found out and was sick within a couple of days. So thankful for that though, because usually having all of those extreme symptoms and that sickness means a healthy pregnancy for me. So I'm very, very thankful for that. I certainly appreciate all of your thoughts and all of your prayers. I haven't uploaded as much the last couple of weeks, and it wasn't that I didn't want to, it's just that physically and mentally, I couldn't do it. It didn't matter how much I wanted to, I couldn't do it. And I hope that soon I am at a place where I can go back to uploading 5 days a week, because I feel like that really gives y'all a glimpse into our day-to-day life and all the things that we have going on. But in the meantime, I'm going to do my best, and I'm going to put out as many videos as I can while taking care of myself and my family. And I know that you all will understand, because you all are amazing. I will be doing another update in a couple of weeks, really kind of going more in depth and filling you in a little bit more, but wanted to kind of just sit and chat with you for a minute about how I was feeling, what all's been going on, feeling sick, feeling nauseous, very tired, but very, very blessed. And if you're not already subscribed, I would love it if you would hit that red subscribe button and join us on this journey and on all the other things that we've got going on around here. And for those of you that are subscribers that are family. I call you family because it really feels like that. I love the community that we have here. YouTube really does mean a lot to me, and each and every one of you means so much to me. Thank you for coming back and watching our videos. Thank you for being invested in our family and what we've got going on. It means so much to me, and I can't say it enough. We love you. We appreciate you, and we'll see you in the next one. Bye, y'all.